ordination. That means they are ready to walk or walking towards the next level in God. Some of them have been ready, but there's training that still has to be done. So I want to just say we have gathered ourselves together for a solemn and holy occasion. We have met here today to set aside these special candidates to ordain them in the gospel ministry. What we do here today continues a great tradition that began 2,000 years ago with our Lord's servants and disciples. We have gathered around and laid our hands on the Christian brothers and sisters called to carry out his word to a lost and dying generation. In doing so, we are publicly acknowledging our own confidence in our brothers and sisters, in his calling into the ministry, and in his ability to carry out the ministry with the help of the Holy Ghost. It is an honor, to be involved in this service. As I said, this is not some new thing that we are doing. Paul is writing to a young preacher named Timothy, and a young man upon whom Paul had himself placed his own hands, and he ordained Timothy to preach the gospel. Paul writes to Timothy, as Paul says, this is the time on earth. This time on earth is short. Before he leaves this world, he wants Timothy to have a good understanding of what his calling and ministries are about. Therefore, Paul takes a pen in hand and writes the verses we have as our text today. Paul issues a clear message to a called man and woman of God. That is the truth I would like to magnify for a few minutes today. Allow me to share some of the aspects of a preacher's call and a ministry call as they are presented to you. I will now have Overseer Jennifer come and present to you the candidates for overseer and their charges as follows. Let's give the Lord a hand, please. Before I give them the charge, can I say something? You know, God is so good.
Yes, he is.
Serve him while you're young. You know, I just had my anniversary, my Lord's anniversary, 30 years. And when I look back here and I saw these two signs, no more excuses.
That's right.
I thought about the first church that my husband and I started. Back then, they had old corner benches. You know what I'm talking about? People don't have altars anymore. Now, we know your heart is your altar. But we had an altar, a mourner's bench. And every time I go in that church to pray, you see the priest goes in before the people and you get things in order because you set the atmosphere. And I go in that church and as soon as I walk in, God say, put your butt on the altar. So I said, okay, God. And I'd go up to that old mourner's bench and I'd sit down on that mourner's bench and God would begin to talk to me. I preached in a holy convocation. My bishop at that time was going through some issues. And believe you me, if you're in ministry, you're going to go through issues. You go from glory to glory to glory. But just giving him a yes, that's just the beginning. But thank God you gave him a yes. Because I know there's people out here in this audience today. God has called you, even as a child. God spoke to children. Give him a yes. He said, give me no more excuses. You see, this is the thing. We're living sacrifices, holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. But can I tell you something about holy sacrifices and living sacrifices? When you ain't dead, you keep crawling off that altar. I thank God for the altar. Even in Macedonia this morning, I just kept hearing God say, go back to the altar. Go back to your first love. When you first fell in love with me, before all the church heard, and before all the lies and the deceit and the riches that you think, it don't matter. You see, if you have Jesus, you have everything. And his kingdom. Preach the word. Be instant, in season, and out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all long-suffering and doctrine. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine. But after their own lusts shall they heap to themselves teachers, having itching ears. And they shall turn away their ears from the truth, and shall turn unto fables. But watch thou in all things. Endure afflictions. Do the work of an evangelist, and make full proof of thy ministry. Now the preacher's mandate means that a person is a person that is to preach the word. To herald refers to a king's messenger to the people. A voice and a sound of the king's word was loud and clear. The message was to be heard and heeded. The messenger was to be respected and unhindered. There was not an ambassador with whom one might negotiate. They were a messenger that must be heard. Because two of you are standing here as overseers with a prophetic anointing, it would be for me as the prophet of God, as the one walking in the deity of the fivefold ministry, to give you this word. As a prophet, one must be clear in what they are hearing. One must also be silent, not quick to gossip, not quick to run to mischief, and not quick to spread hearsay. One must be careful what they say in here. The very words that come out of your mouth, you are now, this day, accountable for. Shut up. You cannot act out of emotion. You cannot use your anointing for selfishness. You cannot speak prophetically just to satisfy your soul. You must be available to God and take your feelings out of it.
Come on.
Everything is not always going to be your word. And just because you are called as a prophet, which is the mouthpiece of God, you still must hear what type of prophet you are. You must not lean unto your own understanding, but always acknowledge God in every step you make. For you are now accountable, not me as your apostle, but you are accountable to God. Another step above an elder. with white gloves. It's not about what you know about them. It's not about your personal relationship. It's not about them being your family. It's about what God says they are. And by the grace of God, when you want to point one finger about that cross, you better ask God what he has about you. Jennifer Davis, as jurisdictional apostle of Redeeming Faith Jurisdiction New Covenant Ministries. I present Jaquay Williams officially as overseer, Redeeming Faith Jurisdiction New Covenant Ministries. I present Crystal Montgomery as overseer, Redeeming shoes on. Amen. We will not have Pastor Big come because we do something that we ain't done in a long time. You got me so excited, I want to run up and down this aisle. It's been a long time, Brandy, since we did the ball. We used to do a lot of deliverance here. It's been a long time since we did the ball. There's mom and dad sitting here because I'm excited. I might run over that thing right there. I feel like I can leave. I'm telling you, I heard Linda's demons cry in this house. Ooh, I've been excited.
Thank you.